This is Skyrim commentary from Shauna Films.
There's Hod's tombstone.
Yes?
One of the first NPC casualties in my game. And now that I'm level 30, NPCs are starting to die all around me.
They should use more finesse.
I'm ever so grateful. Good luck to you.
I think Luca was really happy that you brought his gold claw back. I'm sure you made a good friend.
Vilya's playing catch up with my previous history. So we got this donkey tail situation. Gotta go find a cure for the guy. He's been cursed. He's growing a donkey tail, he says.
Hello, handsome. Oh, that big, dumb Nord thief, you mean? Who stole the bottle and tried to drink me. That's the problem with Nords and bottles. If they see something that even slightly resembles a mead, they have to drink it. I'm sure a donkey tail will remind him to stay away from bottles that don't belong to him. Besides, Kayids have tails, so why not Nords? Well, if you insist, myself, I think he deserves that tail. Maybe just to catch him, what would have happened to me if he had been drinking that bottle? Now, in order to make a cure, I of course need a few ingredients.
I actually went and got these ingredients.
Nightshade.
Normally I'm like, what? I'm not doing it.
I think I'd better make a list for you. Just a moment. Let's see.
Because I wasn't in any kind of rush to find the cure for this guy. I just assumed I had all the ingredients with me. Or Vilya would have the ingredients. Turns out we didn't have any of the ingredients.
One brass, huh?
Some of the ingredients are easy to find, some are a pain in the ass to find.
Here you are. Bring me these ingredients, and I'll find a cure for the donkey tail problem. Just one thing. As a side effect, he might develop donkey ears instead. Is that alright? You really are picky, aren't you? Well, I promise I will do my best to avoid side effects. Now, you better hurry up and find the ingredients. Good.
So this person, this elf is, I want to say she's in Oblivion.
Well, if you say so.
Because she's pretty old. Elves live like 5,000 years or some crazy number. Oh, there's that dang water flipping on me again. Yeah, because Vilya's great-great-great-great-great-great-grandmother, I think, is in Oblivion. But Henry's in Oblivion and she looks almost the same.
Good to see you. Take care of yourself.
I'll be happy to assist you.
Ah, splendid, splendid.
So Nazim got killed outside and she doesn't seem to know it yet. I just kept bugging her and bugging her until she told me. It took like 3 days before she finally realized what happened, I think.
Hey there. Nice work with this one. You make us all proud.
So far, I want to say Girder is the only NPC in my game that hasn't figured out that their husband died.
Stories about dragons, that they can eat the sun out of the sky and freeze a man where he stands.
My kid wants to leave these little ghost things everywhere. I don't think she was in this place. And ever since my son, Aventus, brought home that mud crab, I've been hearing a mud crab in this room. Right here. Right here, I hear a mud crab. So it's probably a dirty edit of some kind. Someone edited this room and added mud crab something. Maybe mud crab food for a table or something. But they had the sound turned on for the mud crab instead of just a mud crab leg. They put the whole mud crab there thinking it was a corpse, but it's a living mud crab, and then they deactivated it or turned off its rendering because they don't want the thing in the house after all, but it's still there, just invisible. So now we got an invisible mud crab. Anyway, I'm just guessing. And it only triggers when the kid brings home a mud crab as a pet.
You've done us a great service. As you wish, my Thane.
So I'm trying to get her to say that her husband died and she hasn't done
it. Yes, Thane. What is it?
She refuses. But then she likes me. NPCs that like me will not say their vanilla dialogue. They're going to say something else.
Just talk a little,
they're going to have modded dialogue to talk to me about.
What are your thoughts on Kayeets? What?
What?
I heard such words from Morrowind Dunn, but I hadn't expected you to share their opinion.
Let's see, it looks like I got rid of immersive winches. I don't see any immersive winches walking about. I'm using the vanilla textures for Whiterun. I installed clever charfs. Whiterun. And I immediately gagged when I saw the textures. I thought, what is this piece of garbage? So I got rid of it, and I thought, you know what? I'm gonna see what does my white run look like with vanilla textures. Some of the textures have been replaced with the farmhouse textures I'm using.
Ah, good to see you again. And I've already received word that the client is satisfied. You have done well for yourself and for the companions.
So I ended up putting authentic white run back in my game.
I don't know what the fight is about.
Because it's authentic.
Not our business anyway. I just need you to go out there, look tough, and scare this milk drinker into submission.
The authentic series of city textures
is the best.
It's the best. It just is.
A citizen of the Rift has asked for our help. It seems that a predator has invaded their home, and someone needs to clear the beast out.
Nope,
hello,
not doing
friend.
It.
I can. It might save your life.
Are you on the hunt? Make me proud.
May the gods watch over your battles, friend.
There is always work for the companions, but there is a more personal task before me. Kodlak's final teaching. I think he was right about beast blood and Sovngarde. I wish to cleanse myself, that I might know glory in the afterlife. I would be honored for you to accompany me, Harbinger. You still bear a head of the Glenmoral.
That reminds me, I think I can use one of those witch heads to cure myself, right?
My soul is now prepared.
Because normally I just cure myself by becoming a vampire. That solves most problems. But I've got witch heads in me pocket, so maybe I could use one of those to fix myself up.
So far, this hasn't been too bad. It's lonely exploring by myself, though.
Because I would like to be a vanilla character once more before switching over to being a vampire.
I'm ready if you are.
Then yesterday, I married an NPC. She's super, super famous, super, super wealthy. She's gonna get married to somebody even more famous, probably, than her. And, I married her.
Oh, what is it?
And I've made her a werewolf. I've turned her into a werewolf. So, yeah. I married a werewolf.
Were you looking for me? Of course. Let's go.
She'll show up in a future video. She's the bee's knees. Sort of, kind of. I'll explain later.
Dig, dweller in the beyond. I'll know your lost unknown and rise to your depths.
I'm tempted to install the racial...
No more could be placed. It was...
Racial body morphs?
I can almost hear them.
Because I noticed that some of my NPCs
I will make the mixture.
They'll have a skinny body, and then they'll have like a big old head on top of their skinny body.
It's very cold in here.
And that bugs me. I don't want big heads on skinny bodies. I don't want small heads on big bodies. And then this Dwemer texture, I don't like it. I don't like it, I don't like it.
What is this? It's just a book.
It's just a book.
The world beyond.
This Dwemer texture comes from Clever Charf's Markarth City and Ruins. So soon after this, I reinstalled the ancient Dwemer metal and overwrote the ugly Dwemer textures this mod came with. And that's weird. It's like... There's nothing on the pages in this book. I don't remember if I tried reading this book before. I guess I have to talk to him first.
Come, my champion.
Then I can read the book.
Now, you have my Agma Infinium. It contains the knowledge of the ages, as revealed to Sarces, my loyal servant. For hundreds of years, it's been shut away from the world.
Then, Hermaeus Mora here.
Septimus was a useful tool for unleashing.
He's got a different texture, so his eyeballs look
now,
slightly different.
It is in your hands. Let us work wonders together.
His tentacles look a bit different as far as textures go. Okay, now I can read the book if I want to. I see. The pages are still blank, though. I always thought there was artwork or something on the pages. Maybe not. The mod I'm using that changes the fonts in the books, maybe that mod decided to just leave the pages blank. I wasn't paying attention. When the guy dissolved and fell to the ground, did he make a clunk sound like he was made of metal? I want to say he was carrying a knife or an axe, but it's hard to tell what that clunk comes from when he hits the floor. At least in my game.
Where have you been?
Where have you been?
All right then.
It's so nice to just talk a little, you and I. I was just thinking, would you be interested if I told you a little about myself? Adrian and Ulfbert are not the only nice people in Whiterun. Hulda, the innkeeper, Michael once said he wanted to teach me how to kiss. Ha! Huh. I taught him how to slap somebody very hard in the face.
Yeah, so I don't like the look of this Dwemer metal. It's too clean. There's no corrosion or rust or anything. Look at that. To me, this is lazy texturing.